direction. Oh my life, where will I go?
What's up, everyone? I'm back. So, yeah. Basically just left off exactly where I left off last episode. And one thing I realized, because I just edited and uploaded episode 10. This should be episode 13 right now. I have a lot of pink on my team. I mean, we got Jigglypuff. We got Blissey. Not you. Not you either. And we got Eeyore here. A little Slowpoke. So, yeah. We got three pinks, two blues, and a brown. Interesting. Well, anyway, we're going to be making our way over to Olive City and then hopefully make our way over to... Shoot, what is that place called? Cyanwood? Cyanwood? I don't know. You know, the place where, the fat dude with fighting type Pokemon gym. Yeah, we're gonna be making our way over to him, basically. And over to the Suicune that's actually a Jigglypuff. And that's kind of what episode 10 was, if you haven't seen it. We found out the identity of Suicune and it's actually freaking Iggy. Like, daggum. I didn't want that. Why would I want something that I can catch on one route easily at level 5? Would I want it to be my level like 40 legendary? Like, it don't make no sense. I'm gonna be right back. And I'm back. Yeah, just wanted to heal up Iggy. Since she took all that there damage. You know, we can't be having a damaged Iggy. Nick Young did too much to her already. That's right, battle me, homie. I miss Ash. That died easily. You die quick too, right? Yeah, you do. Look at Iggy out here, one shot. Oh, that's right, Ghost. Ooh. I got it. Wait. Do you have any dark moves? No, you don't. Go, Shenron! Bite! Yes! Ooh! Level 27! That's what I'm talking about. One thing that is good to know about Gyarados in this generation is he learns something every 5 levels. So he learns Bite at level 20, Dragon Rage at level 25, and then I forget everything from that point on. But I know Hydro Pump is one of them. Hydro Pump is one of them. I think Twister is one of them too, but who wants Twister? Come on, hit it. Yes, go Iggy. And I kind of realized also while editing episode 10, when I added Beyonce to the team, we need 2 Moonstones. We don't even have 1. And I'm still looking for a Waterstone too. Why the heck do we have a Sunstone, no Moonstones, and no Waterstone? Like, we're off kilter here. We're off balance. It ain't cool. Alright. Yeah, that's the right placement. And also, I don't know, does this change to another route, like, the moment you go down towards, Olive? Parasect? Huh. Let's cut you. You ain't doing nothing to me. Don't you dare! Oh, you little... I hate you and everything that you stand for. Poison Cure. Got rid of Paralysis. I just realized I never restocked up on my potions yet. Yeah, whatever, whatever. I don't want to hear what you have to say. Oh, she got a ferret! I'm gonna kill your ferret! Long before your fur ever kills me, even if you keep defense curling. You can stall this battle all you want. I'm still gonna land up on top. End up on top. I say things weird sometimes. Because Fern ain't got nothing on Joy. Plus, I got freaking soft boil. I can heal myself up in an instant. Better than your moo moo milk. Daggummit. Please don't. Yes, it's a new root. It's a new root. Oh, shoot. I gotta battle someone. You're a scrub, dude. Oh, I will end your side up. You freaking scrub. First, let me soft boil. Got my health back. Oh, I hate you. Man. At least you can only do like 3 or 4 damage to me every single time you attack. Sucker. Sucker. Come on, a berry, really? So, let's take this time to talk about something. Something kind of off the topic. Last night was the NBA All-Star Game, and the talk of the town has become Fergie. And I just have to ask, why is everybody acting like Fergie could not hold a note? She could hold notes. She did a style. Whether that style worked or not is what makes the difference. You gotta realize, like, she didn't sing poorly. She sang well, she just sang in a style that apparently connected with hardly anybody. So I just wanted to throw that out there because I see everybody attacking Fergie and I feel bad for her for that because, on the real, she can sing, she sang well. Let's just be real on that. You don't have to like it in order for you to admit whether or not she sang well. People are saying that their ears were bleeding after hearing her. No, they weren't. They were not bleeding after you heard it. Like, if you've ever heard the recording of Marilyn Monroe singing Happy Birthday to John F. Kennedy, it has a similar feel to that, but mixed with the actual ability to sing. And nobody complained when Marilyn Monroe sang to John F. Kennedy. I think everybody's just kind of gotten too used to everything being auto-tuned, including Fergie, that people can't enjoy, like, pure singing, or even different styles of singing. Everybody just focus on mumbling. Mumbling, mumbling, mumbling. Yeah, I said it. I'm kind of a bit of a hip-hop purist. Kinda. Come on, freaking put it back to sleep so I can catch it! And then when I get you to sleep, stay in the frickin' ball! There you go. But yeah, I don't like the state of music today. It's been bugging me for a while now. Thank you! Go. So you don't have to like it, but stop saying that she did a terrible job singing. She did fine singing. It's just not something that worked for the national anthem. Though it is skilled at walking, it prefers to live underwater where there is less danger. Now, Polly. So we have a female polywhirl. I don't know if it's gonna be a polytoad or polywrath. I need to actually figure out what the emulator is gonna be. Like the emulator evolution. Pokemon Crystal Emulator Politoed Evolution. I really do not know what to call this thing. I'm lame. I'm really lame. Squirrel. It's a girl. It's a squirrel. I hate myself. Alright, let's go down here. What was that? No, yeah, you always stand there, creeper. Yeah, I don't care about you either. Stay out of my way! Alright, so let's go ahead and check out what the heck Poliwhirl is. And I wonder if typing changes again for this, depending on whether it becomes a Politoed or not. Normal fighting. Okay, it's an interesting mixture. But whatever. Yes, heal them. Heal them. No, I did too much. All right, so now we have right here where we can fish. However, balls. Oops, wrong button. You missed. Oh, there's no Pokeballs. You're probably gonna be more likely to see some great balls on the side of the screen rather than Pokeballs. Because I do plan on swapping them out for Pokemon that I catch with different types of balls. It's just so far, everything that I've caught that I have on my team, I used a Pokeball for. Interesting concept, eh? And I think there's also a trait up here. Like, normally it's like they want a Voltorb for something, or a Krabby for a Krabby for a Voltorb, or a Voltorb for a Krabby. Have a Sea King, would you like to trade it for my Exeggutor? No. Yeah, your trade is disappointing. You two got anything to say? Well then don't get in trouble, daggone. Cinnawood? Cinnawood. That sounds right. Alright, and there's also a fishing rod in here somewhere. Olivine. That's what this place is called, Olivine. Oh yeah, that's right, you give me strength. You my dude, man. You give me strength. I just had to sniffle twice for emphasis. Isn't there like another house where I get a fishing rod here? It's you. Yes, I got a good rod. Hopefully this gives me a bit more of a variety of what I can catch. Not gonna lie, just looking at the texture of this floor is kind of tripping me out right now. Like, I feel like I could see the individual squares that make up the little squares. Like it's big tiles leading to little squares, and it's tripping me out a bit. Okay, so I can actually catch, like, a total of 2 Pokemon here. No. Not that rod. That was the old rod. I need the new rod. Good rod. Ooh, we got some already. What'd it be? Okay, I'm dupes clausing this. Like, I'm sorry, Tyrogue. I've already got 2 of you. I'm not trying to waste my time getting a 3rd. Dupes claws. I might just want to... Yeah, I'm going to start it. I didn't know where the music was going.
Oh, it's a little Teddy Ursa!
What up, Teddy Ursa? Licking that honey off your paws. Let's give you a little cutsy-doodle. Oh, you did so well to survive that. Let's give you another little cutsy-doodle. Yeah, it's not very effective. Rock type. Alright, and let's sing your booty to sleep.
I said let's sing your booty to sleep.
Stop staying awake. You ain't no insomniac. You little teddy bear, you need your sleep. You young. Dadgummit.
And just for everyone's information, I've already thought of a completely unoriginal name for this one. Already thought of it. It's so basic, you're gonna cringe. It broke out of the Pokeball. Which means now I have to start putting great balls on the screen.
Look what you made me do. Look what you made me do.
Oh, come on. Stay in the frickin' ball. No one likes a rebel like this. I like rebels, but not like this.
We got a Teddy Ursa. It always licks honey.
Why only 4 words for that sentence? It's palms. The palm tastes sweet because of all the honey it has absorbed. Like, that...
That first sentence just felt so incomplete.
Oh, you thought I was just stopping at Teddy? No, 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 no. We're going to Teddy Bear. That's how unoriginal I'm being. If I bet some of you thought I was going to just stop at Teddy. Nah. Who you think I is? What you want, Bill?
Oh.
You know what? Call me next time, too. Call me the next time I fill up a box, too. That would actually be, like, mad helpful. First, let's take a look what Teddy is. Teddy, what you be? What you be, Teddy? What you be, Teddy?
Fire.
Well, looks like we're not adding a great ball to the side of the screen anytime soon.
Oops, no, no, no. However, I do have to do this. Because like Bill said, box is full.
Why is he checking in on my PC, though? That's an invasion of privacy, homie. I hope you know.
All right, we on Route 40.
Oh, yeah, it's Monday. You're Monica. I don't want it.
Thanks for something I didn't want.
Let's go, Eeyore.
I love that Eeyore is still a water type. Dun, dun, dun.
Oh no, it died. What a shame. Looks like we can't get anything off this route. Who are you? What do you want? You're useless. Who are you? What do you want? Okay, whatever. Who are you and what do you want? Oh, whatever. Who are you and what do you want? Okay, whatever. So, no one says anything important. Everybody's lame, whack, whatever you want to say. They ain't worth talking to. Okay. Alright, so now we gotta get all the way over to Cinewood. Cinewood, 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 Wood, Wood. I won't bother really battling with other people right now. Right now, we just gotta make our way over. Dadgummit. Frickin' Paul. Frickin' Paul. You're rock steel. Good. I forgot that he learned high jump kick. He's not using it. I don't know what Venonet is, but it's super effective. Sit down, Paula. Sit down, Paula. Ooh, this is a new route. Yes, we can catch this. Please don't be another lame skip loom. Go, Joy. You're going to have to be a tank, just in case. Dadgummit, always gonna text or recording! Oh my gosh, put it to sleep! You know what? You deserve to die for that, Joy, because you know what? You had
5 chances to put that freaking thing to sleep, and you never did it once! Good riddance!
Man. Didn't get to catch it, because it killed itself, and it killed Joy.
I'm so glad I didn't leave Naruto out for that. That would have been sad. That's why I kept putting Joy out front for situations where it could die, because I didn't care as much about Joy. On my whole team right now, Joy is probably the one that I cared the least about. However, that thing is a tank and a rock type, so therefore self-destruct should not have done all the damage that it did. It did like 90. Okay, it did like 87, but still, how, Sway? We might have just found our replacement already! We might have just found our replacement already! I am like peeking so bad because I'm like, I'm getting so into it. Like my emotions are like overwhelming me. I can't. See, like, I'm really not even mad about losing Joy now. But you guys need to get better with your singing. You guys mess up on your singing way too much. Alright. Ooh, yes. Fabulous. Alright. Get in my ball. Easy. But yeah, now we're gonna have to add a great ball to the side of the screen. Ghastly, what is you? Actually, I'm not gonna have that answered right now. It wraps its opponent in a gas-like body, slowly weakening its prey by poisoning through the skin. Yes. See, I had a name in mind, but I feel like it works better as a boy's name, so I'm not gonna use it. No, wait, what am I talking about? I freaking watch Arrow. Just don't add a W. Shadow! Alright. We her. Okay, where's the land? We already got one of you! Not very effective. Uh-oh. I can't escape now. Oh, it's okay. And we her! Alright. So... I have to put Joy to rest. And I don't feel too bad about it. After we put Joy to rest, we'll check to see what Ghastly is. And you know what? To me in editing, don't even bother putting the sad music on here, right here. We'll have the memorial at the end, because, you know, that's fair. But this is whatever. This is literally whatever. Let's just drop Joy in here. And I can't withdraw anything from there. Switch. And what are you, Shadow? See, I wanted to take you right off the bat.
But I can't just say yes because you're two types that I already have in my party. What can we do? We could do the fire type teddy bear because I don't have a fire type in my party. I have both a normal and a fighting in my party. I don't have a ground anymore. But I don't feel like taking a flying poison. Annie Lou. I don't want to take you with me though because you don't learn anything. Bug fighting, we have a fighting. Bug ghost. No. Fire bug. Flying fire. Bug. Flying. Flying ghost. No. Fighting. Normal dark. Rock. Huh. Normal water. Normal poison. Dragon. I think I'm gonna take Teddy Ursa with me. I actually, my first choice that I was just thinking there, looking through everybody is Ursula. I was gonna take her with me. However, I feel like, wait, what am I doing? I feel like I wanna wait till I get XP share before I do that. Hold on, let me put Teddy Bear back. Because I just forgot about something that you do here on this island. Remember, Dew gives you a shuckle. I'm in shock. A guy about your age with piercing eyes and long hair came in. He scared me into giving him my prized Pokemon. I still have one left, but what if he comes back? You look strong. Could you look after my Pokemon for a while? Sure. Oh, thank you. Take good care of it, please. I received a Pokemon. Its name is Shucky, and it is... How am I supposed to feel about this? How am I supposed to feel about this? This is freaking the evolved form of my first and first deceased Pokemon, Spitfire. What am I supposed to do? Do I like literally accept it? Or what do I do? What do you got? Oh yeah, that's right, you got a berry. Do I throw it in the line of fire again? Do I? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? I don't know what to do. Someone tell me what to do. My brain is crying. Might as well take it, right? Should I use it now? Or should I work on Teddy Bear? You know, let's go deal with the whole Suicune situation up here. And then I'll make a decision. What's this? Oh. No, definitely not. The Pokemon Seer ahead. What up, Jigglypuff? I see all, I know all. Certainly I know of your Pokemon. Shucky. Well, I can't sell a thing. How could I not know of this? Fail! I see. Yeah. Becoming more confident. Okay, whatever. You're useless to me. Bye, Jigglypuff. What up, useless? Yeah, with Suicune. Yeah. It's wonderful. I want to see Suicune up close. I've decided I'll battle you as a trainer to earn Suicune's respect. Put some respect on his name. It's Jigglypuff. Mystical man, useless. It's like U sign, isn't it? Like, let's just hit it with a reversal. Ooh, and it's super effective. The tables have turned. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Level 27. You're flying fighting. Flying fighting, flying fighting, flying fighting, flying fighting. Let's go Eeyore. Yeah, that ain't gonna do much. Confusion. That'll do something. So will this. And so will that Shell Bell. What's the point of raising your attack and defense? Especially when you're using an attack that does the same amount of damage based on your level each turn. Like, what's the point? Oh, snap. I'm gonna go to Iggy. Oh, he got fast. Oh, come on, please. Hit it with a thing! I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this again this episode. I'm not doing this again this episode. All right, you guys need to start hitting your sings. Bite. It doesn't do much. Dragon Rage. Dragon Rage. There we go. We ain't losing another person today. No, sir. What I look like. I hate to admit it, but you win. Duh. I'm amazing. That's the only thing I get out of this other than you're obnoxious and you're not gonna leave me alone for the rest of my journey. Alright. Now I think I have just a little bit of training to do, cause I'm pretty sure that the gym leader's top Pokemon goes up to like level 30. I can double check that. But I think as of right now, this might be just a good place to end off the episode. What's in this house? Do you remember Four Islands? Yes, I do. Okay, whatever. Talk to me! I heard that you can only see if you have a... Whatever. I know you're talking about Lugia, but whatever. I've heard that the whirlpools around the islands are caused by a sea creature. You might need a special move to get past... Whatever. I know all about Whirlpool. And you give me Fly, which I am going to teach to Naruto. Yeah, I know. Ooh. No. Oh, that's right. I have to defeat one and then the other in this gym. But I'm not gonna do that this episode. No, I'm not. This is gonna be the end of this episode. I just wanted to check because I was thinking you could battle one at a time. No, you battle one at a time, but you have to battle both of them one after the other. Well, anyway, we'll save that for next episode. That's it for this episode. Till next time, thanks for watching and deuces. Mama, 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 mama.
so I wrote it in the rhyme. The Reverend Doctor got an 8K wet working. Roaches get the race, spray my weak rhyme, my body, your best verses on game day. I touch the crowns of self-entitled kings. You leave the heat like LeBron when I melt your idols' vital things. This is Malcolm and Martin, million man marching. Sparta mixed with a legion of angels surrounding sons and daughters. Simon Peter with a desert eagle waving it at Caesar. So if I was you, I probably wouldn't mention me either.